Are you a software tester who don't like to work, and are you stuck in your software testing career? In this video, we are talking about, guys, why the most of the QA and testers are unhappy with your jobs, right? So I'm going to discuss about a couple of points. So let's get started. Hey guys, my name is Pramod and welcome to Testing Academy. So today, as you have seen in the intro, we are going to discuss about a very interesting question, right? And a couple of points that I have basically consolidated, right? These are the points basically I think, and I'm going to share my experience why, how you can basically remove these unhappiness and why you have this unhappiness, right? So we're going to discuss step by step what exactly you need to do that, right? So I hope you are able to see my screen, and this is the mind map that I have prepared for you guys. I love mind map, and trust me, these are the points which will help you. So first of all, let's focus on the first point, which is the no learning in the current work. So what I have seen is that like couple of people who are just starting out their career, right, and they are into software testing and they are unhappy. Why? Because of the single problem, because there's no learning. Right, so no learning basically means that they want to learn some automation, they want to learn some other things and all, they want to work on these projects, but they don't get that those kind of projects. They get what we call it the second point, which is monotonous work, right? And in their mind, it is very easy, means you are able to do it very frequently, and it is very monotonous work, so you have to repetitively do the same work again and again, right? So that's why you are unhappy most of the time in the software testing. So this is one, I think these are the one of the first reasons, right? And I'm going to discuss about a one salary aspect of it, right? Also where people are basically comparing the salary with developer, and also that is second point why they are unhappy in that case. So learnings. So as a software tester, if there is no learning in your current company, I would highly recommend, if you can, you have two options. Either you have to change your approach, the way you are doing the work, or either you have to change the job, right? These are two options that you can have apart from it, right? So what I have done is that, okay, so what you can do is that discuss with your colleagues, right? So if discuss with your colleagues, right, okay, I'm doing this work and this is monotonous, I'm not learning and all, get the perspective from them, right? What exactly they think. If they think in a similar way, it means really you are doing some monotonous work and there's no learning for you, right? It can be dangerous for your career ahead, right? So that's, you have to pay attention. Discuss with your manager, see if you can get other tasks. So this is what I have done, and in my previous organization, whenever I was a little bored for the certain time, and I think that was a manual task which can be automated, right? But we don't want to automate because there is no ROI and client don't want it, right? So what I had done is that I had a discussion with my manager, and we had a conversation, okay, let's do one thing, let's put you into a different project where you can work on it. So the new project was a new learning, and that's how my unhappiness, or whatever you call it, right, it was removed in that case, right? So that's what you could do. Third point is basically accept it and learn. So basically my point here is that if you think that you are unhappy with the software testing job or the work that you're doing, accept it. Okay, I'm bored, and now what you can do is that you can learn new things. So what I do means what I have done in the past is that on the Saturday, Sunday, I used to watch videos from the different courses. I took some courses from Udemy, Coursera, and some other websites. I haven't taken a couple of one-to-one courses where I have learned about Selenium, Advanced, Cypress and all, right? These kind of stuff, like I'm talking about like for 3-4 year backs, right? So, and what I did, I basically shared all the things over the internet, right? I created a blog. You have seen my blog, right? Scrolltest.com, do visit it. And shared my knowledge, and I have created a profile over the GitHub and all, right? So you can keep on improving yourself in that case. If you're not learning in the current work, you can basically learn outside of it, basically on Saturday, Sunday, create your framework, learn about Selenium, learn about the different type of framework that they have, right? BDD, keyword driven, hybrid, how they work, to practice it and do some dummy projects. So that's where you can remove your unhappiness in that case, right? So I hope that is clear. I hope you are able to you're able to correlate these things with me, right? Because I have seen people are unhappy in software testing jobs, but trust me, these things will whatever the things that I am going to mention here, right? Trust me, if you take these points, definitely they will help you in that case, right? So monotonous work, how you can remove it, think about ways to automate it. And I'm going to tell you about when I started in one of the MNC, which is very, very famous MNC in this country, like in India. I couple of tasks when I used to do, right? I knew that it can be done in like 2-3 hours of automation, right? So what I did after working hours, I created certain scripts and they loved it, right? But they don't want to use it. Why? Because it basically reduces the efforts in that case, and they don't want to reduce the efforts because they had a client billing. That is a very interesting case, right? They don't want to introduce automation or certain scripts or utilities in this because that will reduce the client billing in that case, right? So that's fine, but that's how I sold my monotonous work in that case. So MNCs and few bigger companies I have seen, they provide lots of monotonous work. But my point here is that if there is monotonous work, there's no learning, accept it and learn on the weekends so that you can improve yourself. And probably in the next company that you are targeting, you could have some automation or some other work which will basically make you more happy in that case, right? One more thing I have seen, which is the third point that I'm going to discuss here, is that you don't know a clear path of your career. Basically, it means no clarity. Let's say no clarity in this case, right? So no clarity with the QA path. So what do you mean by this is that, for example, if I have created a video, I would suggest you go to the sdev.live/QA path, right? So let me zoom out. So I have created a video around it, right? Means what are the different, what is the QA, basically quality assurance career ladder, right? Where you can have a path one, path two. You can become a senior QA, QA lead, test manager, director, test consultant, and different roles that you can do. Like you can even go with a freelancing and all, right? So you should be clear about your career path. If you are not clear, then those things will again make you unhappy in that case, right? So make sure you are clear with your QA path, right? Means I use a very simple principle which is called as to avoid unhappiness. There is a rule of 5 years, right? Which basically says that plan your journey, your salary expectation after 5 years or 3 years, your position, where you want to be. You want to be a QA lead after 5 years or 4 years, and what is your salary at that point, right? So make sure you have a point. So that will basically keep you motivated and definitely will remove the unhappiness that right now you are facing. Third thing is very important, which is basically you never change your life until you step out of your comfort zone. So whenever you are unhappy, it basically means you are right now you are in a comfort zone somewhere. So make sure you do the projects. You can do the project on Saturday, Sunday. That's what I am saying, right? Even if it's a no learning current environment, make sure you put some efforts and make sure you whatever you are learning on Saturday, Sunday, take some courses. If you are interested, go to learn.testingacademy.com. There are a couple of courses that you can organize courses that I have created. You can check them out. You can take Udemy courses also. That's not again, I'm not against all those things, so you can do that. So the one point which I missed here is this point, right? So salary, right? Most of the people are unhappy with their job in a software testing is because of the salary differences with a developer. They try to compare themselves with this salary of a developer. And if you know, as a fresher, when I started, right, it was very different in the India, right? So if we talk about developer salaries are here, tester salaries are here in that case. So difference is huge in that case, right? But I would say that after 3-4 years, it's become same, right? I don't know about the USA and Europe where the salary difference is not much between the QA and dev, but here in Asia specific, especially India, Pakistan and all the Bangladeshian people, where the salary difference for QA and dev is very, very large. And I think after 4-5 years, it becomes same. And right now, even in India, like in Bangalore and all, people with a QA profile are getting some great, decent, very decent packages, salaries, right? As compared to the developers in the same web. So after certain years, it became the same, but initially, yes, we have these kind of difference, but I think that should not demotivate you. If you are someone who's interested in learning software testing, who's interested in finding bugs in other code, right? who always try to break the code, whatever the things, and you fall in the category of software tester, then you basically love or passionate about, right? So that's where I think that's actually make the difference, right? So overall, in the conclusion, I would say why most of the people are unhappy of their job, because of the monotonous work, no learning, salary differences, and they are in the comfort zone, right? So I hope you have learned something new in this video. I hope you will pay attention to this point. I'm going to link this mind map in the description as export, so you can check it out anytime. Make sure you watch the video of sd.live/QAPath to get the clarity about your career, right? Thanks a lot for watching. And also, I would like to know, what do you think about this? Why you are unhappy in your job? Comment down below. I'll be happy to reply. Thanks a lot for watching. I'll see you in the next video.